See, they gave an amount. That amount is including tax. Including tax means we call it as amount paid. VAT paid by shopkeeper is one case, and VAT deposited to the government is other case. Total VAT deposited, already we paid 240. We remove remaining. Writing, understanding the given problem and writing this equation is important. Indirectly speaking, the total VAT provided by Radhika now. Welcome to the session, dear students. Today we'll go ahead with the problems of sale tax and VAT. So now, refrigerator is marked for sale for rupees 17,000, which includes sale tax 10%. Calculate the sale tax in rupees. See, they gave an amount. That amount is including tax. Including tax means we call it as amount paid. So I can say, given amount to be paid. Amount to be paid they gave. What is the amount to be paid? Amount to be paid is rupees 17,000. This is given. Now, other than this, they told sale tax percent. They have also given sale tax percent. Sale tax percent is given 10%. And they have not given market price. So, market price is not given. We'll assume it as X. Let X be the market price. So, now you know the format. So, market price, we'll assume let MP or we say X be the market price. Let X be the market price. Now, amount paid formula, amount to be paid or amount is equal to market price plus sale tax percent of market price. So amount to be paid we know 17,000 rupees and market price is X and sale tax percent is 10% of X. 10% means what? 10 by 100 of X. So this is given. Writing, understanding the given problem and writing this equation is important. Total amount to be paid is market price plus sale tax percent of market price. Always we calculate sale tax for market price. So now market price we don't know, we need to find. So X be the market price. So sale tax percent is 10% and of X. Simplify this. If you simplify, you will get 17,000 is equal to X plus, I can cancel 0, 0, X by 10, take LCM. If I take LCM, 10 is the LCM. 10x plus x, 11x by 10, 11x by 10 is 17,000. So now rearrange and solve for x. So x will become 17,000 into 10 divided by 11. Now simplify this. If you simplify, x is equal to 17,000, 170,000 it will become divided by 11. 11 ones are 11. So 60, 11 5s are 55, 50, 11 4s are 44, 60, 11 5s are 4, it goes on. So now I can round it off to 15,454. So now therefore market price is equal to rupees 15,454. This is the market price. Do they want market price? No, they want sale tax. Find the sale tax. So therefore sale tax is equal to sale tax percent of market price. So sale tax percent is 10%, 10 by 100 of 15,454. 0, 0 cancel. When you divide this, see now dear students, you got including tax amount is given. So just you can subtract. Now they want sale tax. So they are interested in sale tax. So sale tax is equal to amount paid minus market price. Amount paid is 17,000. In this remove market price 15,555. So subtract this. 17,000 minus 15,454. 10 minus 4 is 6. 9 minus 5, 4. And 9 minus 4, 5. And 6 minus 5, 1. So we'll get 1,546 rupees approximately. This is the sale tax. So 1,546, yes, paid sale tax. So when you add 1,546 for this amount, it will become total amount paid. Total amount paid minus market price. They have not given market price. We have to calculate market price. We calculated market price from the total amount paid. They gave total amount paid is 17,000. From this amount, remove market price, whatever we got. When you remove that, you will get remaining amount. Remaining amount is tax. So for market price, 15,454 rupees. If you pay a tax of 1,546 rupees, then it will become total amount. So they want sale tax. This is the amount of sale tax he paid. Then a furniture dealer sold furniture for 21,000 rupees and added 5% sale tax to the quoted price. The customer agrees to buy it for 21,000 including tax. See, actual price is 21,000 rupees plus tax, but the customer is bargaining and he want to pay only 21,000 including tax. So find the discount received. Whatever the discount is received, we have to calculate. So dear students, when you calculate real amount, so amount, actual amount, first we'll take actual amount to be paid. Actual amount is market price plus 5% tax of market price. That is market price, they have marked 21,000 rupees. For that, he is supposed to pay 5% tax. 5 by 100 of 21,000 rupees. This is the amount he is supposed to pay. If you simplify this, 21,000 rupees plus 21, 5 is a 5, 1 is a 5, 5, 2 is a 10, 0, 1050. So he is supposed to pay 22,050 rupees. But he is not paying so much, he is paying only 21,000 rupees. The remaining amount is discount for him. So discount is equal to actual amount to be paid, actual amount minus amount paid. So actual amount he has to pay is 22,050 rupees, but he is paying only 21,000 including tax. So he is getting a total discount of what? 1,000, whatever the sale tax, this much. 1,050 rupees is the discount. This is a discount. So what is the discount? 1,050 rupees. And if he agrees to pay tax of 5% for this, it will become 22,050. But in spite of paying 22,050, he is purchasing the item only for 21,000. So he saved 1,050. This is a discount given by the shopkeeper for him. Now, a shopkeeper purchases an article for rupees 9,000 and sells it to a customer for 10,500. And if the VAT is 4%, find the VAT paid by shopkeeper. See, two cases. VAT paid by shopkeeper is one case, and VAT deposited to the government is other case. VAT paid by the shopkeeper, and if you have only one, one transaction, so say VAT paid by the shopkeeper is VAT percent, simple, of selling price minus cost price. What is the VAT percent they gave, dear students? They gave VAT percent is 4%, 4/100% of selling price minus cost price. So he purchased at 10,500 and he sold at 9,000. So 10,500 minus 9,000. VAT is calculated on this. So 4% of, subtract this, 10,500 minus 9,000, sorry, that will become 1,500. 10,500 minus 10,500 minus 9,000, that will become 1500. Two zeros cancels. And we have 15 into 4, 60. So therefore, VAT paid by shopkeeper is 60. VAT paid by shopkeeper is equal to 60 rupees. 60 or rupees 60. Sanju, owner of a jewelry shop, purchased earring for 2000 rupees at 12% VAT and sells it at 2300 rupees to Radhika. And if Radhika also pays 12% tax to the shopkeeper, how much did shopkeeper deposit to the government as VAT? See, please understand here, two transactions are done. Every time, see, first, if I am the purchaser, I'll pay VAT to the government and I'll purchase. And if I am selling it, I'll collect the VAT from the other customer and I'll hold what I have paid, and remaining again I'll deposit. So for every selling, VAT is collected. So what we should do is, VAT paid by shopkeeper, paid by Sanju will calculate, then VAT paid by Radhika will calculate, and total VAT deposited to the government will calculate. So each step we have to calculate. So now VAT paid by Sanju is simple. VAT percent into whatever the VAT percent into cost price. For what cost he is purchasing? VAT percent, what is the tool? 12%. 12 by 100 of 12,000 rupees he'll pay. 12% they give VAT percent. See, there are two. See, last case it is only one transaction or one time is purchasing, but in this case we have two cases. So first Sanju purchases and Sanju again sells it, so therefore two times VAT is collected. So 12% means 12 by 100 of cost price. For what rate is purchasing? 2000 rupees. Two zeros cancels. 12 to the 24, 240 rupees he paid. Sanju pays this. And VAT paid by Radhika is equal to VAT percent into cost price. What rate she purchased? So VAT percent is 12% into cost price. What is the cost price? Cost price is 2300. Two zeros I'll cancel. 12 3s are 36, 12 2s are 24, 24 plus 3, 276. See, dear students, see, total VAT deposited, already we paid 240, we remove remaining. So remaining amount, so now the VAT paid, total VAT deposited to the government is equal to the first case. Sanju paid 240 rupees and Radhika will not pay. Radhika will pay 276 for Sanju. Sanju will deduct his 240 and remaining he'll pay to the government. So Radhika pays 276, but in that Sanju keeps his 240 because already paid. So remove that 240, so it will become 240 plus 36. So total it will be 276. That's it. Simply speaking, total VAT deposited to the government is Radhika's money. Why? Because first Sanju purchased it and he paid 240. Then he'll collect from Radhika 276. In that collected 276, he'll keep his 240 because he already paid to the government. No, he'll keep his 240 and remaining 36 he'll deposit to the government. They're asking you what is the VAT paid by Radhika. They're asking what is the VAT deposited to the government. So if for the government, first Sanju deposited 240, then she will pay as VAT 276. In that Sanju will collect his 240 and remaining. If suppose Radhika sells this article to someone, she will collect all the VAT from that person and he'll hold her 276, remaining she'll deposit to what? Government. So advantage of VAT is what? Every sale, VAT is collected. I hope all of you got it. What we have done? First, VAT collected by the, VAT deposited by the Sanju, we got. And then VAT deposited by Radhika, we got. And we subtract these two and we add it to the deposit. Total VAT deposited is 276. Indirectly speaking, the total VAT provided by Radhika now. Early first phase, Sanju has given. Second phase, Radhika will give to Sanju and Sanju hold is 240 and remaining, he will sell it. So 240 plus only this much is gone to the government, deposited. So first it is already deposited, now this is deposited. Hope all of you got it. Now we will go to the other cases of VAT in my next session. Please sit and revise this problem. So I will see you in my next session. Thanks for attending. Thank you.